Hello everybody, I want to tell a story. When you play video games often, you may experience moments that you can never repeat. Things that you are proud of, or things that you build up. There are some of these incidents that I will never forget. And one of them happened 9 years ago. And right now I want to talk about that gaming experience. I was once a notorious gang leader with over 130 members in an online game. To be more clear about it, the gang I built became so powerful and so threatening to the order on the server that the admins decided to ban me and in this way free the people on the server from my actions without actually breaking any server rules that were reasonable enough for a lifetime ban. I didn't record any videos back then. The only thing I have left from that time are the memories and a few screenshots. Let me start at the beginning. I have a good friend with who I played Left 4 Dead with for a number of years, until we decided to mess around in Multi-Theft Auto. Multi-Theft Auto is a program that allows you to connect to a wide range of servers built in the game Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. These servers have a high number of game modes, and we went to the server with the most numbers of players, which was a roleplay server. In this server, you had to do boring jobs to make money, which in the end were quite pleasant because, of course, it was all happening in GTA San Andreas freaking online. This server had a few strict rules, one of which was that you could only shoot players in Las Venturas. If you did this in another place, you got wanted stars. And if a player who was police arrested you, you had to serve time in prison. Even if you were shot in a place where this was not allowed, you also had to take a screenshot and post it on the forum of the server so that the person who shot you got a temporary ban. I mean, this is Grand Theft Auto, and on top of that, San Andreas. It was a little bit like Grand Theft Auto 5 online, where most of the players don't understand that Grand Theft Auto is Grand Theft Auto, and not The Sims or anything. Of course, the server had other things you could do to make money, like racing, robbing a bank, or selling drugs. You could harvest wheat at a specific location every hour if you had a harvester vehicle. There was also a drug factory, where you could make your own substances. All this you could sell to other players afterwards. Each substance had its special cheat effect to give a temporary advantage to the player in certain situations. So, I spent a while as a truck driver and selling drugs until my friend suggested to create a gang together so we could do turf wars. Turf wars also earned good money without it taking too much time. And there was a lot more action because if you want to take over a turf, there is a chance that the gang who owns the turf arrives and defends it. To capture a turf, you had to stand in the turf area for like 10 minutes. And if you manage to stay in the area, you captured the turf. And the color on that area changed in your gang color. During one of our first gang battles, we were pleasantly surprised by another gang defending their turf. They came across with a truck that was an empty platform on wheels at the back. There were like 5 members of that gang standing on it, shooting at us while they drove around us. So, from now on, we were busy taking over turfs. After a while, we got a small number of members who fought with us to take over turfs. After some time, my friend came online less and less until he stopped playing MTA. I, on the other hand, felt it was not enough. GTA 5 didn't exist then, and GTA 4's online was very limited. I wanted to continue, and that was the moment where I decided to take my role as a gang leader as seriously as possible. Some players wanted to be a good taxi driver or a proper police officer. Others wanted to clean the street from papers and dirt. On the other hand, I wanted to play a more appropriate role for roleplaying in San Andreas Online. So I became that big-mouthed gangster who wanted to put his footprint in the server. I knew I needed more members to reach my goal, so I scouted for other players like me. For example, players who did not care much about the rule that you could not shoot each other outside Las Venturas, or players I often saw again when I was in prison four times, or players I often spotted in the drugs factory. I recruited them by guiding them through turf wars and stated that it was important to respond to calls to defend turfs. The members who were ambitious were given a higher rank in the gang so that they could also invite and recruit other players to the gang. Every hour I went alone or together with members to harvest the wheat from the wheat field. Any other players who were waiting or also arrived were chased away by us. Many players complained about this to moderators and admins. A few times they told me to share. The wheat field is for all the players, they said. When my gang is online, the field is theirs. That's what I said. Other admins agreed with me that what I was doing was playing a role in a roleplay server. It depended from person to person. One admin was so annoyed by the fact that he couldn't kick me for this, that he came to see me to shoot me or to hunt me away. Alone or sometimes with loyal players. But my loyal members always prevented even admins from taking over the field. The players on the server who wanted a part of the field had the only option to join my gang or not to get involved with us. In the server you also had a cell phone that you could use. One of the functions it had was sending private messages to other players. Whenever I had to serve prison time, I also engaged in seeking new members by sending messages to players who had the potential to join us. Yes, it was possible to use a cell phone in prison in San Andreas. And I have used that enormously. I had prepared a message explaining who I am, info about the gang, details of what to expect, promises that if they back me up, that they would get richer faster than with catching fish or something. This message was very detailed and also very attractive. I also kept my word to all members and guided each member through all of our activities. This was the only way to make sure they would know what to do. If I had scored new members while I was in prison, they would often be waiting for me at the police station for my release. When the gang got bigger, I didn't even have to be present on the turfs. Members mentored new members and so on. And defending and capturing turfs became a priority for the majority of the gang. I had it well done. Another thing I often did when I was in prison was giving orders to members to go out and kill the player who made me end up in prison. Of course, my members who did it got paid for me, because sometimes they end up in prison with me. It was funny, because I was able to read the server chat while in prison, and I could see when it happened. And when they asked why they got shot, some members used to answer not to mess with the gang or with the leader. I'm not sure how much time I've spent in prison in that server, but it was a lot. Of course, moderators came to tell me not to encourage other players to violate server rules by placing a bounty on another player and hereby provoking gunfights outside Las Venturas. But that didn't really interest me. I had already tasted the taste of power. It was not the time to take a step backwards. Often, when someone in the chat just challenged us, I would send a few members to them to give them reason not to challenge us. Also often, depending on which way that player challenged us, he was also offered to join the gang in exchange for being left at ease by us. Towards the end, I had so many members that there was a 24/7 fight for the turfs. On some days, there were as many as 40 or 50 members online at the same time, with the majority active in Las Venturas. Other members and I also went to the drug factory to make substances to share among the members so that they could run or shoot faster, which all worked in our favor. But to be fair, I was mostly in Las Venturas to defend the turfs. When we took over a turf, I challenged the member of that gang in the chat. I said stuff like, "What are you gonna do about it? Come on, defend your ground." I did what I could to provoke other gangs, to have them come to us so they could get to know the power of my gang. If and when they arrived, a wall of guns awaited them. I posted messages on the server forum to the gangs whose turfs we had taken over, with of course screenshots of the turfs that were no longer theirs. From this moment on came the real challenge. All the regular and loyal players of the server found out who we were. Every staff member now knew of this big-mouthed gang leader and his gang. This meant more members for us, but also more enemies. Of course, I was often muted by the moderators, but then I let the conversations continue through the gang chat, so other members could reply in my place. They were muted too, but I paid them. From now on, the real action started. The real big gang fights. Several gangs became friendly with each other to try and defeat us together. Players who joined the gang, who just wanted me to shut up in the chat, we were finally starting to get the reputation I worked for. Sometimes this reputation backfired on me when people tried to surprise me and kill me. Of course, they were tackled afterwards themselves and often other members of the same gang who had nothing to do with the attack, just and only to send a signal back to the leader of that enemy gang. There were also gangs who didn't bother with us at all, and others who came discreetly to propose to work together. My answer was always simple. Hey, I don't need any help, buddy. My gang is unbeatable. How about you remove your gang and join mine and become undefeatable yourself? Sometimes this worked, sometimes it didn't. But again, I gave them the only choice to join me and not to work together as different gangs. All the turfs had to become the property of my gang. When I noticed during fights that there was a player from the opposing team who was really good at shooting and aiming, I approached him at a later time with a proposal to join my gang. I gave them an offer of $50,000 to fight for me. Members from other gangs I knew of were getting $10,000 from their moderator gang leader every week. To some of those players, I even offered up to $100,000. I had managed to get some of their best shooters to join me. Oh, this pissed off a lot of people. But business is business. Besides police, the server also had other services, such as military. These services generally did not interfere with activities in Las Venturas, but on a few occasions they assisted other gangs in an attempt to defeat us. In addition to firepower, we also had other means that were helpful in ensuring our victory. Players could be a medic and heal us during turf battles, so we didn't have to keep getting shot, spawn again, and go back to where the battle took place. The medics were also automatically paid money every time they healed someone. A medic was also one of the jobs on the server that you could do. Sometimes, we also had a few members who took on the role of policemen during turf fights in order to arrest members of the other gangs who had wanted stars. This decreased the amount of guns the other team was using against us. I had so many active members that during turf fights, I could command members to go to the drug factory, also to chase players who were not members of the gang but still encourage other gangs in the chat, and even to send them to other turfs in Las Venturas to defend them. This caused the opponents to spread out to multiple locations, and so I was able to send larger groups of members to overpower them every time. A few times, when we were online with a huge number of members, we paraded in Los Santos with 15 or sometimes more vehicles, cars, motorcycles, even helicopters. We drove slowly through Los Santos because that's where most of the players were present. On the radar, a smudge of icons of members of my gang appeared. Other players were drawn to this and asked questions, paraded with us, some joined the gang because of the impression we made. There was also a downside to the parading. This was also a challenge for the police in the server, as most of the members constantly had wanted stars, and for other gang members in Los Santos. Sometimes this led to a small battlefield, with many arrests and temporary bans as a result. Then the moment came when the rumors of my gang got on the nerves of one of the top admins in the server. He teleported to me where I was to interfere with my activities, shot me, and warned me that if I shot him back, that he was going to ban me for life. Other moderators and admins ignored it because he was one of the top admins. I was also smart enough not to comment on it. Just as he was wasting my time, I did this with his time just by keeping my mouth shut. This also got on my nerves after a while, so I reported this correctly on the forum. This started a storm of criticism because apparently it was my own fault that the admin came to provoke me like that because my gang had become so big and so strong. Then he started to stalk me for a while. just standing on my vehicle so he wouldn't have to walk. He waited and just stand there. Waited for a reason to ban me. But he couldn't. I was smarter. I called out more members to come to see me via the phone. And admins weren't able to see messages that were sent on the phone. I asked the admin how his day was. What he had eaten that day. To get some reaction. But nothing. Then about 15 members stood by me. All staring at the admin. I remember one asking, "Do you want to join our gang?" But most were asking, "What are you doing here?" Pointing out that we were not breaking any rules. He said that at that moment, if someone started to shoot at him, that it would be reason enough to remove the whole gang from the server. After a while, that admin stopped behaving this way. But he made it clear to me several times that he would treat me different from all other players. But that did not keep me from continuing my task as a leader. The turf fighting continued, until we took over all of Lens Venturas for the first time. This was also unseen on the server. Never has one color ruled the whole city before. Many players hated us for this, but many other players also congratulated us. All members of my gang who were online at that time received a bonus of $20,000 for that achievement. These bonuses were listed in regular chat and not the gang chat, so many gang members switched it to my gang and more players on the server were interested in joining. From this point on, other gangs had no chance at all against the strength of my gang. Turfs that were attacked or taken over were immediately overpowered by members of my gang. Players complained about this a lot. One admin said it's the game and they had to defend themselves. The other admin told me to share with other players. It was also not stated anywhere in the server rules that sharing was mandatory. We had literally became unbeatable. And that led to a legendary moment. The biggest fight I had in the period I've played on that server. Me with about 30 members of my gang versus 3 big gangs at the same time. They conspired against me and thought they could teach us a lesson. I don't know how many opponents they were then, but I can tell you that it were at least as many as on my side. My gang was in a multi-story parking building and the opponents across the street on the Sphinx Pyramid. They shot us from the pyramid, from the ground, tried to enter the parking building by all means, through the ground floor, with parachutes through the roof or through the sides of the different floors, but they had no chance. This fight took over more than an hour before they gave up. My members who ran out of ammo got money from me to buy new ammo so they could continue to defend. This was a very extraordinary moment, one that I had never experienced in my time as the leader of that gang. We even took over the turf that the opponents attacked us from while the fight was still going on. They fled and the victory was ours. Las Venturas was still our possession. After this extreme moment, I thought it was the right time to take some group photos. The screenshots I showed are from after the fight. Just look at all these people. All for the sake of the gang that I built. We needed more space, so we moved to the airplane graveyard to take further pictures. This caught the attention of the military base that was nearby. Soldiers who were online at that time came to have a look to ask what was going on, as they never saw so many activity in that place. After we introduced ourselves, they also wanted to take pictures with us. For a few days later, we continued in Las Venturas and our other activities continued as usual. The moment soon came when other players no longer had a chance to make money from turf wars. This led to a massive fight throughout the server. Many players demanded my ban and the removal of my gang. The chat was bursting with arguments and discussions. To keep this part short, the admin I talked about earlier was called up and ended it by banning me and deleting my account, and thereby removing the gang from the server as well. Everything I built then disappeared in a snap. But what happened next was very interesting. A member of the gang, with who I also spoke to on Skype, told me that after the gang was removed, the entire server was at war. One half was against the admin's actions and the other half approved. This caused the entire server to shoot at each other everywhere. Imagine all the members of my gang that were online then lost their gang. They were pissed off and wherever they were, they started to shoot everybody. Remember the rule that you could only shoot each other in Las Venturas? Well, nobody cared about that at that time. admins and moderators had their hands full with kicking and banning people. There was chaos like never before, but this also marked the end of this unique gaming experience. And that was how my empire was built and destroyed. In response to this ban, I started creating a server myself, one with fewer rules and more fun. This was a very large project that I worked on for a very long time. This server also became quite successful, and I will show all this in another video soon.